Live from the Virginia Commonwealth University Siegel Center, Chesterfield County Public Schools is proud to present the commencement exercises for the class of 2023. This program is made possible through the cooperative efforts of Chesterfield County Public Schools and Virginia Commonwealth University.
Good afternoon, parents, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the commencement exercise of James River High School, class of 2023. Because we wish to honor our graduates in a special way, I ask that you silence or place on vibrate all electronic communication devices and cell phones. Please rise and remain standing for the entrance and procession of the party platform and the James River High School faculty. ladies and gentlemen, the James River High School class of 2023.
Thank you. and gentlemen, I am Rohan Sharma, the Senior Class Council Vice Chair. Please remain standing for the presentation of colors by James River High School's NJROTC Color Guard, the Pledge of Allegiance, and the National Anthem, performed by the James River High School Band, Chorus, and Orchestra, under the direction of Mr. Stephen Kunkka, Ms. Catherine Hazelwood, and Ms. Jody Austin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Candidates for graduation, class officers, parents, and invited guests, good evening and welcome. It gives me great pleasure to declare the 28th commencement exercises of James River High School, a nationally recognized school of excellence, to be in session. Assisting with this evening's ceremony are members of the James River High School administrative team, Mr. Mike Farrell, Mr. David Kern, Ms. Leah Mullis, and Ms. Arnold. I welcome and thank our distinguished platform guests for being with us tonight. Dr. Mervyn Darty, Superintendent of Chesterfield County Public Schools. Representing the Midlothian District, Chesterfield County School Board, the Honorable Mrs. Catherine Haynes. Representing the Midlothian District, Chesterfield Board of Supervisors, the Honorable Mark Miller. The Honorable R. Lee Ware, Jr., Member, Virginia, House of Delegates, 65th District. The Deputy Superintendent, Dr. Joseph Tylas. Our Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Sharon Pope. Our Chief of Schools, Dr. Lisa High, Director of High School Leadership, Dr. Belinda Merriman, Director of the James River High School Specialty Center for Leadership and International Relations, Mrs. Lindsay Smith, School Counseling Coordinator for James River High School, Mrs. Marcy Bennett. And ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and pleasure to introduce to you the chair of the 2023 Senior Class Council, Bowman Novy.
I've opened every assembly this year in one way. For one last time, what's up? Welcome to our graduation. As class president, I'm grateful to have the opportunity to speak for our class. We may have been on different paths, but they have led us to where we are today. Gathered here in the Siegel Center, we give thanks to everyone who has helped us along the way. Thank you, Jane Zerber. Thank you for all the tough times and lessons taught. Thank you for allowing us to feel success, but also for allowing us to experience failure. You've created an environment open to experimentation and growth. When we walk into school, we feel safe knowing that there is a community in the building that is there to make us succeed. Your walls house the most resilient, strong, and supporting group of people. Thank you for being our home for the last 4 years. Teachers, thank you for being there for us. We know we haven't always made it easy for you, but we wouldn't be here without you, and we can feel your support. Ms. Prunansky, especially, thank you for not taking my weak excuses for being late to your class and holding me accountable. Teachers, you're the backbone of our community, and the ones who are constantly supporting us in whatever challenges we face in and out of school. You're there to stop us when we're gonna do something not so smart and push us forward when you see the spark of light within us. You've changed our lives for the better. Thank you. We all have a few teachers who become almost family to us, giving us a safe space and someone to bounce the hard questions and ideas of life off of. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts for being who you are. We could not have made it without you. Thank you, administrators, for supporting us. We know we have caused you some trouble, but deep down in our hearts, we're grateful to have you there for us. I cannot start to imagine how much work you all are putting in behind the scenes. We are so very lucky to have you. Mr. Curran, you reminded us a while back that this is the last time in our lives that we will have this strong of a support system. I want you to know that we appreciate that support system and we acknowledge how very special that support system is. We cannot forget to thank the people behind the scenes, our custodial staff, lunch staff, and everyone else at Jane Zerber who has helped us along the way. We see you working day in and day out and cannot be more thankful for you. I've really enjoyed our brief interactions and hellos in the hallway. We give our biggest thanks to our mom, dad, and caretakers. We fight, we fuss, we give you a really hard time, but you still support us through it all. You've seen us fail, fall flat on our faces, and you're the first person to give us a helping hand up. Even after watching all the stupid things we do, you are still there to pick us back up. I cannot count the number of times I've seen my mom shake her head at me and call me what she likes to say, a ding dong, after making the same mistake over and over. I don't know how she's able to stand there and not get frustrated at me. You are our greatest supporters and number one fans. We look up to you every day. You're the sole reason we've made it to where we are today, and we want to give thanks to you. Mom, Dad, I love you. Lastly, let's give thanks to each other. It's been a rough year. We have been through a rough year together, and this year has gone by so fast without giving us a chance to feel how we want to feel. I want to remind everyone to give themselves the opportunity to feel those hard feelings. Booth, Will, Mateo, we wish you were here with us, but we know you are here smiling in spirit and laughing at your friends. We have one of the strongest communities here at James River, and I'm so thankful to be a part of it. There is no other place on earth where someone could find a community nearly what we have here at James River. I don't know another place where I can high-five someone in the hallway who I don't know and have the same feeling of mutual camaraderie like James River. I'm really gonna miss what we have, but I'm looking forward to what communities we will make better. You all make the world a better place and have made the last 4 years of my life the best they could be. Let's celebrate today. Go Rapids. Please welcome the Superintendent of Chesterfield County Public Schools, Dr. Merv Doherty.
Good evening. Good evening. So there seems to be a lot of energy when the students were coming in, and you're going to have several speeches. So adults that are here and friends of the students, we're going to help you relieve some of that stress right now. So I want everybody to stand up. Everybody stand up. This participation. And on the count of three, I want you for 5 seconds, yell your child's name out as much as you can. One, two, three. Thank you. All right, thank you so much. Now, in order for us to get through the program, which is the most important part of you hearing your child's name being given. So I want you to know, class, at 3:30 in the morning today, I woke up and I said, the script that I have, the speech that I have today, wasn't good enough. So I'm ripping up my speech that I was given today. And what I'd like to say to you is this. Congratulations. This is my 148th commencement speech, and I have the same beginning and end of my speech for 148 times. I would first like to ask anyone in the audience who has served in our military or is serving in our military, would you please stand to be recognized? Thank you for your service. Rapids, any students, graduates that will be going into the military, will you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Now today we have three types of students sitting before me. We have the student that is worried about the future. We have the student that's worried about walking across the stage. And then we have the students that's worried about both. So here's some advice for the future. Two things that I believe no matter what you want to do, if you possess these two qualities, you'll be successful and go far beyond your goals. Be kind and respect others. Second, be honest and have integrity. Two characteristics that are lost in our society today. And you will shine above all others and be noticed as a leader when you possess them. Now, for those who are worried about getting their diploma today, these are very important instructions, so pay attention. You will stand up. You will walk to the ramp. You will come across the stage. You will shake the principal's hand. You will walk off the stage and go back to your seat. If you follow those instructions, we're going to get out of here, right? I have the privilege today to give two superintendent scholarships of $1,000 each to students selected by the faculty who will be attending schools in Virginia. You do not know who it is, so when I call your name, please come forward to accept your scholarship. Going to Virginia Tech in the fall, Parker Forster. Second, also going to Virginia Tech, Margaret Domasi. Finally, wonderful time for graduation and celebration. But starting tomorrow, I have a challenge for you. Get off your couch, walk away from your PlayStation and social media. Make sure you know the goals you want to set. Wake up from the dream and step forward and attack the process of being successful. You will be far ahead of most people your age by just saying, I'm willing to go forward. Take the risk. It's worth it. This is something that your parents probably haven't said to you yet, but we have really two high expectations. Get a job and pay taxes. In closing, I leave you with this. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and give you peace. May the Lord watch over you and guide you in every step that you take, and may you see his grace every day. Class of 2023, we believe in you. God bless you.
Please welcome the Vice Chair of Chesterfield County School Board and our Midlothian representative, the Honorable Catherine Haynes.
Today I'm going to acknowledge to everybody that I hold a bias. All school board members are supposed to love each school equally, but I don't. James River holds a very special place in my heart. I feel a deep connection to the JRHS class of 2023, and it's not just because my entire family got sick with the horrible respiratory illness. It was a cold, not COVID, that the cross-country team had the race where I saw Bowman run a race sick as a dog. This class was in ninth grade when COVID started. You had just enough of a normal ninth grade school year, September to February, to fully enjoy your newfound identities and the freedoms of being in high school and out of middle school. And then schools closed. I was a new school board member, elected 4 months before the pandemic. In November, I felt the freedom of the campaigns, and I remember the early days of the campaign awkwardly clutching my note cards before my debut campaign speech. I remember I was told either master the art of public speaking or get out of this race. Yes, the campaign trail was a lot like middle school. From January to February, our school board bonded quickly and dove into budget season with high hopes for our ability to shape the bright future of our schools. And then our nation put school boards in charge of the return to in-person learning. In September of 2020, you all had to come together and try to connect over Zoom for the entire 10th grade year. You never had the luxury to be slacking sophomores. Many of your home lives were literally falling apart. Parents losing jobs, taking care of younger siblings, your cohort had to grow up really fast. Late summer, fall 2020, my world began to fall apart as well. Taking the time to finally pursue and then find support for an ADHD diagnosis gave me the tools to put the pieces back together. We can do hard things. I think that being deprived of each other right at the beginning of high school made your class more genuinely appreciative of the strength of our school community. By the time you were all back together, you were 11th graders. One thing that I have learned about your class, you are fierce. And that is another trait that we share. Although as a class, I will admit you discovered your strength and resilience decades before I did. While too many adults today choose polarization, you, the class of 2023, embody the CCPS logo, hashtag better together. So what are you going to do with your knowledge? It is an election year, so you might begin by making sure that you are registered to vote. If you have college plans outside of Chesterfield, stay registered in this district and order your absentee ballot. This is still your home. We need you, and we could use your vote to ensure a better tomorrow. Class of 2023, like you, I am graduating to the next phase in my life. The pandemic altered my life path. The next chapter is one I could never have predicted 4 years ago. I'm relocating next year to support my parents as they age in place. My family will move ahead of me while I stay behind in Chesterfield to complete my commitment, my term on this school board. Hard, yes, but doable. Because in Chesterfield, I have found a community, especially in this high school community. Throughout our life, we seek belonging. When we are lucky, we find spaces where we can be our full, authentic selves. When we find community that sustains us, we nourish it and make the necessary sacrifices to keep our community strong, even when we move on physically. Class of 2023, together, and perhaps a little bit more than some of our other communities, know that without community, we have nothing. And with community, we can move through anything, no matter how hard. Thank you.
Please welcome our Midlothian representative to the Board of Supervisors, the Honorable Dr. Mark Miller.
Go Rapids! Good evening, class of 2023. I'm Mark Miller. And I have not only the privilege to be serving as your Midlothian District Supervisor on the Chesterfield County Board of Supervisors, but to speak before you today, thank you for this opportunity. Graduates, it is such a pleasure to be part of your special day. I'm continually impressed by the caliber of the young people we have in Chesterfield County. And this class is absolutely no exception. Congratulations to each and every one of you on this outstanding achievement. Now, I have to be honest, when I graduated from high school, I felt fairly lost, overwhelmed as to what I would do next. I knew I was heading to college, but what I was going to do, as I look back, proved to be more of a process than a destination. When I completed my doctorate in clinical psychology, I remember my father said to me right after graduation, he said, "How did you ever get your doctorate? I didn't think I'd get you through high school." I guess that kind of says it all. I wasn't much into high school. I was an okay student. But to be honest with you, I wasn't all that engaged. I was pretty lost. I didn't know what I wanted to do. And even when I graduated from college, I was still just a bit lost. The famous psychologist Carl Rogers wrote the following. He said, "It seems to me that a good life is not any fixed state. It is not, in my estimation, a state of virtue or contentment or nirvana or happiness. It is not a condition in which the individual is adjusted, fulfilled, or actualized. The good life is a process, not a state of being. It is a direction, not a destination." Through the years, I've noticed two kinds of graduating high school students. One kind of student is the one they know exactly what they want to do next. It's kind of like going out to dinner. These students know exactly what they want for dinner. Is it Chinese or Italian or whatever it is? You know, they know what they want. If it's engineering or information systems or wants to be a nurse. The other kind of student is the one where they're really far from sure as to what they want to do. For these students, I suggest that they select the buffet and go out and explore. Both paths are perfectly okay. At the buffet, you get to try a little of everything. If it's going to take college, take a bunch of courses for which you have some interest in, and then see how it tastes. Be it English, or history, or sciences, and chemistry, biology, anatomy, and physiology. It's not going to try, if you're not going to college, try working all different kinds of jobs. Save money, travel, try new things, meet new people, and ask them about their life path. Two types of students. Some know after high school what they want. Some students need to explore what they want. So, when someone asks you what you want to do with your life, it is perfectly to say, "I'm exploring my options." And it is perfectly okay if college isn't on your list. The goal is to explore your options. Even if you know exactly what you want to do, there is a lot to admire for those who like to explore the buffet of life that offer a variety of experiences. As you experience the buffet of life, you will find foods that you will like. Others will be incredibly distasteful. As you change and grow through the years, you will experience challenges, unexpected disappointments, and even tragedy and personal loss. You will experience lovely interactions with others, incredible accomplishments, and surprises along the way. As you collect these experiences in your life, it'll be as if you're fashioning a wonderful, colorful quilt. A patchwork of pieces of cloth placed together into a story of your life. Some of those pieces of cloth will be easily placed into the quilt. Other experiences, perhaps not as easily as you attempt to integrate a specific experience into the essence of who you are. But know this, during those incredibly difficult times, it will seem as if you are in the middle of a hurricane. The winds will blow like crazy during what can be scary, horrible tornado. It'll be difficult to know where and who to hold on to. Yes, the weather can be powerful, challenging, and even terrifying. So will some of your life's experiences. but also know that the weather is always changing and variable. In the middle of a storm, it can feel like it will last forever. Hold on to those you love, those you trust, and don't forget to breathe. The storm will pass. I promise. I do really promise, but in the midst of the storm, it will feel like it's not going all that well. It will take patience, trust, hope, and a belief that even though you know that you are being tested, you can see the storm through. I encourage each of you to own your humanness, accepting yourself just as you are cultivating inner strength and an ability to withstand any storm that comes to your shore, and whatever form it arrives, be it criticism, failure, disappointment, and or loss. The only question is how. How are you going to react to the situation? How will you handle the strong winds and the drenching rains? And then, once the storm has passed and you have some perspective what you've been through, that is the moment. That is the moment when you assess whether that experience is ready to be integrated into the quilt of your life. If not, it's okay to put that experience, that piece of cloth on the shelf, at least for a little while. It'll be there when you are ready to integrate that experience into your life's lessons, which leads you to wisdom. My dear high school graduates, please know that you're going through what clearly has been found to be the most challenging time of your life. You're in a transition phase as you move from being an adolescent to a young adult. I call these years, if you haven't already figured out, the years of the storm. Starts around 14, goes to about 24. It's going to be a challenge to transition from seeing the world through the eyes of someone who, up to this point, in many ways, was clearly established to get through high school. From here on out, it's going to be a bit more confusing. Lots of choices, lots of opportunities, but please know this, and if you don't get anything from this commencement speech, please get this. There are very few choices that can't be undone. So choose well. A career path can be changed. Who you are in relationship can be changed. Where you live or go to college or where you go to work can all be changed. What cannot be changed are life and death decisions. Never let desire impede judgment. Never let desire impede judgment. Make smart decisions as you partake in the buffet. My dear parents, friends, guardians, and family of the newly graduated student, I offer to you the best advice I ever received regarding how to now interact with my daughters, now 23 and 20. So I'm about to share what is current for me. My job as a parent is to transition from everyday daily parenting to becoming an everyday daily cheerleader. It's really hard for me, and I suspect for many parents in this arena, to keep my opinions to myself unless asked for, and then cheer loudly when the highest rooftop, when your young adults find success, happiness, achievement, and especially their path, even if it is ever-changing. So in short, even if it might be tempting to offer an opinion, just listen. To our incredible Chesterfield County teachers, support staff, administration, thank you. Thank you for all the blessings you give to our students every day. On behalf of the supervisors, let me share with you how incredibly grateful we are for all that you do every day. What you do is a gift of love, and these graduating students are a testament to your success in helping to guide them along their journey. I want to share with you these lyrics from Harry Chapin's song, A Story of a Life. I can see myself, it's golden sunrise. Young students, open up your eyes. It's supposed to be your day. Now off you go, horizon bound. You won't stop until you've found your own kind of way. And the wind will whip your tousled hair, the rain, the snow, the sun, the sweet despair. Great tales of love and strife. And somewhere on that path of glory, you will write your story of a life. Graduates, thank you for sharing this momentous occasion with me. I am truly honored to be spending this time with all of you. On behalf of the Chesterfield County Board of Supervisors, I extend my sincerest congratulations to each of you. You've made us proud, and we wish you the greatest success as you write your story of a life. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hazelwood. I would now like to recognize the salutatorian and valedictorian of the senior class of 2023, who each have impressive weighted cumulative GPAs of over 5.0. Ladies and gentlemen, the salutatorian of the class of 2023, Clara Franklin. Clara, you have set yourself apart with your outstanding work and achievement for over your 4 years of high school here at James River. We congratulate you and want to present you with this gift in recognition of your impressive academic accomplishment.
Good evening, fellow graduates, faculty, friends, and family. Everyone can agree that high school has always had its ups and downs, and our high school experience has been particularly challenging and unconventional. But we overcame everything the last 4 years has thrown at us to be here tonight. Helping me get here tonight were my mom, dad, brother, and sister. Thank you, and I love you so much. Please take a moment to give a round of applause as a thank you to whoever supported you and cheered you on. With ninth grade abruptly ending and then spending a year of school only seeing each other's faces on a computer screen, we started missing out on the true sense of community that comes from being together, working together, and even just seeing each other in the hallways. Our teachers did an excellent job of trying to keep everyone engaged and motivated to keep going. So I'd like to take a moment to thank each and every one of them and let them know that their hard work and dedication did not go unnoticed. Those difficult times made me appreciate and cherish the small everyday moments of high school that became lost. When you look back on high school, you're not going to remember a big test you were worried about or a presentation you were nervous to give. You're going to remember getting new assigned seats and sitting next to someone you've never talked to before and becoming great friends. Connecting with your teachers when you hear little tidbits of their lives. Trying your hardest not to laugh with your friends when you know you're not supposed to. Going down Robius Landing with your class on a nice day. Chit-chatting with your friends in the parking lot before and after school. Cheering on fellow Rapids at sporting events, finding joy in teams like Speech and Debate or clubs like Woo Ball, Foursquare, the Rapid Rowdies, and Anime Club. We had some great moments during our pep rallies, like the rope breaking during tug of war, and Mr. Hodges making a half court shot backwards. You never know what amazing things could happen unless you take that shot. When I was told I was gonna give a speech at graduation, my immediate reaction was absolutely not. Public speaking has never been my forte, so being told I would have to speak in front of thousands of people was just the best news ever. I honestly was thinking about turning the speech down, but after taking a bit to let the news settle, I decided why not. If I had said no, I would not be up on stage right now, seeing the beautiful view of all of your hopeful, excited faces and the proud faces of your friends and family. After all is said and done, the risk is usually worth the reward. Therefore, my advice to everyone here is to do the things that scare you. You may crash and burn sometimes and soar others, but you'll at least be proud that you tried. It's better to know you took the risk than to have to wonder what could have happened or what you could have been capable of. When we look back, it's in the things we do, not the things we don't, that we get to add to our little joys of life. As we finally finish this chapter of our lives, I hope you are proud of yourself for getting through the tough times and keep the small good moments close to your heart as you start your next chapter. Congratulations, and with whatever path you take, I hope you soar.
Now I'd like to recognize that, you know, y'all are really frisky tonight. And we're going to get to the good part in just a minute. So can we hang on? Can you hang on? I'd like to recognize the valedictorian of James River High School's class of 2023, Hannah Herzog. Hannah, we congratulate you and want to present you with this gift in recognition of your accomplishment.
I am beyond grateful for this opportunity to represent the James River Class of 2023 as we take this next step together in our lives. I want to first thank God for this achievement and every other blessing he has given us. To our teachers and staff, thank you. Thank you for the endless support that we received. I truly feel like I am coming out of high school, not only stronger academically, but better prepared to take on life. And I hope my classmates had a similar experience. Thank you for caring about us and making it more than just a job. To the families and friends, thank you. Not only for being here today, but every day, and providing consistent support. Classmates, take a second to find your people and give them one last wave. Sorry. To my parents, thank you for all of your sacrifices and patience throughout the years and for teaching me countless lessons. I am grateful to have such a large family that loves and encourages me unconditionally, and I hope everyone has these people in their lives. To my fellow graduates, congratulations. I know it was not easy, and we should be proud of our accomplishments. Thank you for years of memories, both good and not so good. From dripping sweat on the dance floor to screaming our hearts out at Gary as he chased Rapid Man around the gym. All we ever wanted as kids was to grow up. I remember counting down the days until I was allowed to date. Who didn't wish for summer break every year? But now that our final break is here, we wish we could go back and have a little more time. I could not have asked for a better group of people to grow up with. As a military child, I thought that a place would never feel like home to me, but you all have become my home. And now we are leaving home and starting over again. Now that we are finally graduating, we can confidently say that our high school experience was unlike any other. We were greeted with a national pandemic closing our school the first year, followed by a virtual sophomore year. We came back heavily restricted junior year and tried our best to have a normal last year, but were met with something no one could have seen coming. For those who are unaware, three of our seniors have passed away this year. Mateo Castle, Nick Booth, and Will Hammett lost their lives suddenly, affecting our class strongly. Grief struck us hard, bringing people from every corner of the school together as we mourned. They were loved, and they still are, by all of us. One thing everyone can agree on is that they were too young. And this has impacted a lot of our lives. We are thankful for the time that we had with them, and we are reminded to live our lives to the fullest. Speaking from experience, as I stand here at graduation, we do not regret not studying longer for our math tests, but instead, we may regret not taking more time to show our friends how much they mean to us. As you move on, whatever your next step may be, make sure that you relish life. Travel the world, get married, become the president, climb the mountain, follow your dreams, wherever they take you. We want to look back at our lives one day and not think of the should-haves, but instead be able to say that we did something, or at least tried. One of my favorite memories from high school was trying out for the volleyball team with absolutely no prior experience as a sophomore. I even lied to my closest friends, not telling them I was trying out to avoid the embarrassment of what I was expecting to be a failure. But even with my serious lack of coordination, I made the team. I wish that I had been told earlier in life that it is okay to fail. Failure is the only way to achieve success. Mistakes make you human. In life, we are constantly faced with uncertainty, but sometimes you just need to hold your breath and take the step to see what is possible. Occasionally, you will take too big of a step and take on more than you can handle. But learning to get up again and take another step is what is most important. Let's use these lessons we have learned in the first 18 years of our lives to guide us in our future. Thank you again for taking the time out of your day to listen to me speak. I would like to leave you with one last thought. As Les Brown once said, life has no limitations except for the ones you make. Do not limit yourself. You are capable of so much. I believe in you. We all believe in you. God bless you, class of 2023. I will miss you.
In a school community as large, loving, and supportive as ours, we know that there have been hardships and losses for many of us over the course of these past 4 years. It is no secret, however, that the class of 2023 has suffered significant losses this year. At the beginning of the school year, we lost a beloved English teacher, Mike McCarthy. In January, we lost a sophomore, Tice Lewis, followed by the loss of three seniors, Nicholas Booth, Mateo Castle, and William Hammett. At this time, I would like to pause and acknowledge those Rapids who are no longer with us. The class of 2023, the faculty and staff of James River High School, and our greater Rapid community have been forever touched by these individuals. The families of our senior Rapids, Nicholas David Booth, Mateo Finch Castle, and William Davis Hammett, are with us tonight. It is my honor and great privilege to present their diplomas to their families. Accepting their diplomas are Nick's sister, Maggie Booth, Mateo's brother, Elijah Castle, and Will's brother, Cooper Hammett. portion of tonight's ceremony that you have been anxiously awaiting. However, before we begin calling you forward, I'm going to take one last opportunity to share a few thoughts with you. When your senior year began in August, I knew there was something different about you. As we've said a few times, at our first pep rally, when the tug of war rope snapped in half, your reaction to that snapped rope caught my attention. Do you remember what you did? Do you? You hugged it out. You hugged it out. Moving through this school year, I've been continuously impressed by how you treat each other. And since that first pep rally, I've been thinking about what I would say to you today. What meaningful words could I, your principal, say to you today? What could I say that you would remember? I could use a lot of smart words. I could use a lot of future-oriented phrases. But the more and more I thought about it, the more I realized what I need to say to you are things you already know. You already know how to be brave, as you have faced many challenges in your 4 years here. Your ability to overcome challenges, whether in class, a pandemic, on the field, on the stage, or in life, has made you resilient, competitive, and most importantly, kind. You are, in fact, a very special class. And I think you are my favorite. I believe with all my heart that you, the class of 2023, are ready for the world. Being rude is simple. It's easy to walk past someone and keep your head down. It's easy to get stuck in the frustration of things you feel that you are entitled to. Comparing yourself to others, what others have or get to do, is the worst distraction of all. And comparing yourself will prevent you from recognizing your own very special gifts and talents. Each one of you is your own unique self, and the world needs you just the way you are. Kindness is a choice, and it shows great self-discipline and self-esteem. Being kind is not always easy, especially with dealing with mean people. Kindness is the sign of a person who strives for wisdom, self-understanding, and compassion. When you choose to be kind over being right, you will be right every time. Thank you for that. You may have grown tired of hearing me say to you each day on the morning announcements, be kind. It's easy to tune out things you hear repeatedly. Even though you have heard me say a million times, be kind, to me, it's the same as saying, I love you. Those are very powerful words, and we can never hear them or say them enough. As time passes and life happens, and you find yourself out there in the world, getting the job you wanted, meeting those deadlines, buying the house, having the children, traveling the world, whatever choices as adults you make, there will be times when you remember the simpler days you had in high school. And when you think back, I hope what you remember is that you were treated with kindness. If you have learned anything from me, from the faculty and this great community we call James River High School, I hope that what you remember most is that kindness always wins. And again, when you choose to be kind over being right, you will be right every time. Class of 2023, your unique talents, gifts, and kindness shine very brightly. And I firmly believe you are ready to take on the world. As your very proud principal, I'm going to say to you one last time, and maybe you'll say it with me, be kind, always. That your displays of enthusiasm, affection, and recognition be withheld during the announcement of the candidates for graduation until the very last name is announced, so that all names might be heard. At this time, would the candidates for graduation please come forward to accept their diplomas, preceded by the valedictorian, salutatorian, and senior class council. Mr. Mike Farrell will announce the names of the graduating seniors.
Hannah. Hannah Joy Herzog, Clara Kendall Franklin, Bowman Yoa Novi, Rowan David Sharma, Grace Caroline Pereira, Rayleigh Grace Brewer, Avery Jane Brooks, Taqwa Ibrahim Abeldehe, Carlina Stephanie Acosta, Yesli Niley Anhal Moran, Jacob Connor Akanituk, John Tyler Alexander, Samir Ahumadi, Dakira Kathy LaFay Allen, Franciel Da Silvia Allen, Sierra Lachey Allen, Sebastian De Jesus Alvarez Leola, Antonio Jose Artiga Munoz, Owen Elijah Ayers, Michaela Renee Bagley, Daquan Terrell Bailey, Francis Riley Baker, India Ansora Baker, Catherine Margaret Bale, Kendall Grace Bailey, Leonardo Daniel Barantes Rosales, Jasmine Michelle Barron, Marshall Bates, William Grayson Batt, Eliza McKenzie Beavers, Tavi Simone Bergia, Efren Jose Bernal, Zachary Robert Betts, Rithika Sri Bahavitula, William Brant Bickett, Brooke Ashley Bingenheimer, Emery Tanner Bishop, Naomi Chanel Blake, Ashley Michelle Blanco Murillo, Kamari Jakai Bowler, Cindy Guadalupe Bonilla Carranza, William McKenzie Boswell, Margaret Kimball Bothwell, Benjamin Jordan Bradley, Isadora Maria Braga, Stephen Isaac Braga, Marin Gemma Catherine Breadbenner, Adair Madison Breeden, James Allen Bridgeforth, Justice Josiah Devine Brokenbow, Landon Kaylee Brook, Gianna Charlize Brooks, Cooper Rivers Brown, Owen David Brown, Skylar Carlene Brown, Riley Evelyn Brown, Nakia Simone Bryant, Thuong Ho Tan
Dimitri Boltron Hernandez, Kylie Sue Calhoun, Lorenzo Miguel Camacho, Christopher Manuel Canas Lazo, Charlie Madison Carlton, Daniel William Carter, Bridget Madison Cash, Daniela Nicole Castillo Tavar, Jalen Jacone Causey, Daryl Emmanuel Chambers, Jacob Robert Chaplin, Idris Nasir Maddox Chase, Deanna Marisol Chavez, William Chen, Jackson Richard Cherry, Zane Grant Childress, David Cho, Camille Marie Coley, Preston Scott Comer, Stuart Arcana Comia, Kylie J. Cordero, Sophia Marie Cordovana, Miguel Angel Corrales Anrago, John Patrick Costello, Luther Jack Covert, Isabella Cowan, Archer Harrison Cox, Brianna Alize Cox, Sebastian LaSalle Cox, Laurel Catherine Kraft, Lee Robert Craven, Abigail Lauren Crawford, Kimberly Vanessa Cuellar, Jada Chanel Lauren Cunningham, Douglas Lamel Cupertino, Liam Rain Costello Evenstar, Avery Noble Daniel, Ava Taylor Darden, Tanner Gordon Davoud, Megan Elisa Dawson, Gabriel Michael Dean, Raj Kashin Davin, Ian Murphy Dyerly, Samuel Eller Dyerly, William Ernest Dyerly, Dylan Ray Diaz, Candice Renee Dickey, Neo Nizega Dina, Clayton Reed Dobler, Dexter George Dotson, Raina Elizabeth Doggett, Margaret Elisa Domasi, Evelyn Vanessa Donato, Scott Colin Donovan, Martha Amory Doyle, Gabriella Dean Duff, Caitlin Riley Easterling, Marissa Kimberly Eggleston, Doyle Scott Ennis, Dylan Stephen Espana Hernandez, Jordan Patrick Etz, Peter Westbrook Falls, Xavier Deontay Coron Farmer, Ash Ryan Fernley, Graham Shaw Farrington, Cody Thomas Ferguson, Jose Alejandro Figueroa Escobar, Amanda Rose Finch, Anton Tyon Reginald Fleming, Damon Anderson Flowers, Jamin Deontay Flowers, William Martin Ford, Parker Bradwin Forrest, Felicia Noel Franco, Chloe Kara Franz, John David Frieda, Caroline Rebecca Ferdet, Karis Luane Frade, Moises Julian Fugan Gutierrez, Carla Elizabeth Garcia, Rosalyn Mia Natasha Garcia Escobar, Kellen Marie Garka, Casey Logan Garnett, Jacob Conley Garnett, Isaac John George, William Bryce Gerald, Connor Patrick Gibbons, James Acree Gibson, Andrew Stephen Gilliam, Daniel Egan Gillis, Daniel Tubar Kia, Catherine Julia Glazier, Ashley Gomez Vicenta, Rachel Elizabeth Gonzalez, Edwin Jose Gonzalez, Miguel Angel Gonzalez Martinez, Samuel Patrick Gossel, Lily Catherine Goslin, Sean Sullivan Gould, Jalen Rachel Granados Sanchez, George Daniel Grant, Shauna Therese Grau, Emily Claire Green, London Mariah Griffin,
John Francis Bosco Grinzel, Alexis Gutierrez Tobar, Jillian Delane Hackett, Ellie Grace Hagler, Nashawn Devon Hall, Nashana Diamond Hall, Eliana Janae Hamilton, India Tylea Harden, Chloe Marianne Hargrove, Dylan Harkett, Isabella Kivon Harris, Brandon Fultz Harvey, Adam Hassan, Virginia Lucille Hawkins, Zazuria Sherilina Davinia Hendrickson, Jeremy Hernandez, Jacob Milton Hess, Mallory Elizabeth Hess, Lily Grace Hester, Kyle Hauser Hogan, Saul Ethan Holliday, Benjamin Edward Hopkins, Cooper Scott Hoyle, Bonnie Shu, Morgan Romero Hall, Sherman Donnell Hunley, Samantha Kate Hutchinson, Yasinia Elizabeth Iniguez, Isla Janela Izaguerra Bonilla, Arshe Dominique Jackson, Gail Jimenez, Aaron Lynn Johnson, Erica Joyce Johnson, Miles Jaden Johnson, Sydney Elizabeth Johnson, Lindsay Irene Johnston, Devin Antonio Jones, Kimberly Samantha Juarez Portillo, Elizabeth Marie Uri, John Alexander Justice, Colin Kaufman Key, Taylor Nicole Kelly, Ryan Thomas Kelly, Ethan James Kleinholz, Sawyer Woodson Klein, Avery Elizabeth Knight, Emma Genevieve Kostal, Ashton Michael Kuntz, Timothy William Kruger, Ashley Nicole Lanez Calix, Andrea Yesenia Lanez Tremino, Parker James Landergan, Noah Whitley Landis, Turner Jefferson Landrum, Quentin Antoine Lassiter, Isabella Rose Latouche, Riley Cole Lahoon, Krista Marie Lawrence, Charisse Alexander Lawrence, Nathaniel Kevin Lyle, Emily Joe Layton, Alexis Pham Lee, Jack Thomas Leedy, Darwin Macri Letterway, Robert Ian Lee, Danielle Janae Lewis, Hannah Elaine Lewis, Reagan Augusta Lewis, Avery Lois Liuza, Emily Jasmine Lizama, Isaiah Amory Lloyd Bowens, Lanier Avon Logan, Lily Valentina Lopez, Martha Alicia Lopez, Kaylee Lopez Sierra, Antonino Vito Lopresti, Lila Gordon Lowry, Jessica Esmeralda Lewis Lopez, Sam Luther, Thomas Todd Mago, Kara Janice Maldonado, Rachel Mann, Zara Elise Marshall, Evan Wells Martin, Adon Manuel Martinez, Ashley Areli Martinez, Amber Sophia May, Brooklyn Niana May, John Michael Jamal May, Olivia Jocelyn McCall, Janaya Monet McCleary, Wyatt Edward McIntyre, Addison Lynn McFall, Amanda Kayla McNeil, Eva Raven McCray, Yara Linda Medrino, Abner Rodrigo Mejia, Jonathan Edwin Mejia, Andrew Irving Melton, Scarlett Naomi Meneses Pineros, Kyle Jermaine Middleton, Kelly Janae Anaya Miles, Tanae Iona Miles, Jose Fernando Milian Carazaco, Casey Joshua Miller, Hillary Michael McBride Mills, Ella Josephine Milton Benoit, Tina Marie Mitchell, Alex Shion Miyazaka, Fatima Tofiq Monasir, Waleed Tofiq Monasir, Riley Sue Montgomery, Abby Lala Moore, Mathilde Amadine Moral, Molly Catherine Mulligan, Brennan Michael Murphy, Jamil Anthony Meyer, Anastasia Jane Nebashowski, Samuel Lee Newton, Timothy Wayne Newton, Mintu Nguyen, Vincent Quang Nguyen, Bradley Joseph Nichols, Kendall Monroe Nichols, Bear Maskins Del Nicola, Makia Princess Unique Normant, Avery Ray Norgard, Devante James Ochola, Jackson Edward Olawani, Jose Carlos Orina Hercules, Anna Catherine Osterhout, Benjamin Carter Pace, Henry Michael Page, Kira Alil Pantazas, Nathan James Parker, Jax Clayton Parton, Mitchell Lyons Percy, William Wilson Peeler, Allison Rose Penzak, Marco Antonio Parada Mora, Kurt Allen Augustine Perez, Emmanuel Perez Merciano, Anna Christine Perry, Matthias Pitcher Jacob Phillips, Siren Emily Phillips, Ella Elizabeth Fithian, Nathan Matthew Pierpont, Samuel Dylan Poor, John Bernard Price, Madeline Alexander Proakis, Rocco Abigail Quinella Monge, Niogabo Raphael, Jillian Nicole Rao, Melanie Sophia Reyes Martinez, Hannah Caprice Rudy, Kylie Mae Richards, Ava Pearl Riley, Jack Michael Riley, John Connor Riley, Owen Robinson Riley, Jalen Kanako Rios, Connor Stephen Rivas, Carlin Cavanaugh Roach, John Caleb Roberson, Marvin Fernando Rodriguez Uyo, Daniela Rodriguez Amaya, Marlon Yassid Rodriguez Legazamian, Najee Khalil Rodwell, Issia Marie Rogers, Reese Marie Rogers, Xiomara Romero, Sandra Elizabeth Romero Vasquez, Jacob Edward Rothenbach, Caden Alani Rudd, Abel Augustine Rudolph, Brennan Joseph Rusher, Katori Renee Ryan, Caroline Meredith Sadie, Catherine Carter Sadie, Muhammad Safain, Daphne Abigail Salazar, Shelby Manyard Sale, Mariah Jose Sanabria Morales, Josue Enemas Sanchez Diaz, Cameron Lee Sapp, Sky McKenzie Sapp, Noelle Elizabeth Schleider, Nicholas William Schreiber, Kenzie Ann Scott, Kylie Madison Scott, Samantha Grace Seibert, Shannon Michaela Self, Alan Christopher Shepard, Brooks Judson Scott Shepard, Hyun Shim, Cole Scott Simmons, Javier Singh, Emily Wren Skinner, Jackson Brady Skinner, Addison Louise Smith, Kennedy Brooklyn Smith, Augustus Joseph Smithson, Kaylee Campbell Sneed, Matthew Amadeus Snyder, Fergie Luana Scuola Castillo, Lila Elowin Soravio, Kelly Ann Sparks, Charlotte Grace Stoss, Grace Lloyd Stefaniella, Zachary David Stevens, Mitchell David Tauber, Lucas David Taylor, Michael Ethan Sensen Texan, John Edward Tennyson, Xavion Lamar Terrell, Michael Alexander Thomas, Benjamin Quinn Thompson, Maya Evelyn Olivia Rose Tilton, Audrey Helene Tomez, Charles Henry Tomlin, Josiah Brendan Tonkins, Faith Naya Felicia Torres, Teresa Marie Solis, William Isaac Joseph Tucker, Julia Morgan Underwood, Zacharias Roberto Urbina, Chelsea Diana Urbina Bonilla, Baron Graham Vandermeer, Jacob Allen Varvel, Ami Renee Vaught, Carlos Cy Villobos Mariquin, Valeria Bailin Vila Senor, Abigail Justice Wade, Kellen Shaw Wade, Grace Ann Ting Wagner, Marzell Laverne Walker, Koa Gabrielle Wallace, Rylan James Warner, Clara Lynn Watson, Matthew Donald Weaver, Lois Burnell Welch, Brianna Lee West, Celine Deborah McBride Weston, Jaya Elizabeth Montel Whaley, James Nelson White, John Christopher White, Devin Tremaine Williams, Shade Kiera Winston, Brody Ray Wolf, McKenna Marie Wolstenholm, Anna Marie Wood, Shemaya Anai Wright, Edison Anthony Zalo Brito, Jenna Elizabeth Zachary, William Anthony Garcia.
And graduates, please stand for the singing of the James River High School alma mater, lyrics written by two graduates, Emma Hines and Georgia Scott. Would the members of the graduating class please remain standing? Everyone else can be seated. Thank you. Okay, graduates, we're going to move our tassels from the right to the left. Dr. Daugherty, I certify that these candidates have met the requirements established by the Commonwealth of Virginia and Chesterfield County, that they are eligible to receive their diplomas. I declare the 28th commencement exercises of James River High School adjourned. Students, we're going to recess with the platform party first. I know what you want to do. I do, but we're going to get out of here in the right order. The platform party, let me just say it, and then you can do it. I'm going to say it, but don't do it yet. The platform party is going to recess out. The teachers are already lining up for that tunnel of love. There they go. Are you ready? Do it!